I remember Sean writing Audio Blood, and I remember he had written out some words, and then he had like the verse melody where you have like the background vocals that like steps down during the in the verse, and it was just so cool.
Audio Blood was crazy. People loved that song. I mean, there's this crazy thing that people just started doing on their own accord, where on the bridge, where it gets all quiet, they would crouch down, and then when the last chorus comes in, they all explode.
It was always a spectacle. We never quite knew what to expect. There would be like these almost evolving memes that the crowd would like communally like pick up on and learn that would be directed back to us, and we would be like, oh, okay, I guess we gotta do this part of the song that way because everyone started clapping to a completely different beat, and we're doing that part now.
It's just one of those things where like I couldn't tell you when it started, but it's cool and it's unique, and other bands we played, they'd be like, what's that? What's going on? Like, this crowd knows this band. If there was ever any doubt that like what's up with this Matches band, like I think that at least got people's attention.
It started initially with like 20 people or so, and then when we played our final goodbye show at the Fillmore for 1,200 people, they all crouched, and it was like, oh, that's a lot of people on the ground.
That song was really about the L3 scene that came, and like the fans and the community of bands at that time. So I think it really reflects where we came from, and also reflects back to the times of when you're, you know, and teenager and starting to go to shows for the first time, or like, I think for a lot of people, they can identify with that time of like when you're discovering who you are.
Audio Blood was about L3 and that scene in the Bay Area. So I think it's another kind of important timepiece in the sort of the Bay Area Matches legacy.